Hope you don't find the money strapped to my thigh.
You can go to college and get your little PFD or whatever the fuck it's called. I don't care.
I think you're freaky and I like you a lot.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing.
Go ahead.
I want to get into it, man, you know.
Go ahead.
Like a sex machine, man.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in to Wheeler's Weekend Jams Radio, Episode 4, now beginning, up and running. That is right. February is right around the corner, and we are living in the world of the internet. That's what everybody does nowadays. The internet. The internet. The internet. Now, a lot of people tend to post whatever they feel like, whether if it's their opinion. And there's a lot of negative Nancys out there. And that world just needs to stop with the whole negative aspect on everything. Now, how to deal with that negative? The quicker you have a successful and visible career, the sooner you'll have to face more and more powerful negations to your activity. This manifestation of resistance to what you do is not that big or important as people tend to make it. A negative opinion is no better than a positive one in terms of popularity either, because it will still be about you. Acceptance of negative opinions is also a good exercise of sympathy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you have to know your facts. You have to know the storyline. You have to back up your argument. Know the reality of it. Don't just Google it, but experience it. Remember that. Don't just Google it, experience it, okay? Based off of the reality. People who try to argue with you on a way of just looking things up and then giving their opinion in that detail is not always right. It's pretty much wrong, actually. If you actually, in whatever case you are arguing about, you have to put yourself in that situation or base it on your reality. If you experienced it, then you actually have an actual interesting opinion or know what you're talking about. People could write anything they want about any story, but unless they actually went through it, then they'll have a better description and detail on it. All right, understand that, people. Remember, don't just Google it, experience it. All right, and I have some upcoming, I should say an upcoming great band from Sydney, Australia, called Ipso Factopus. And they just came out with an EP called Trouble. Check them out on their Facebook. I'm going to be playing one of their new songs here. It's called Rowboat. So enjoy, and I'll be right back.
Thank you. to be.
What's meant to be.
Feel now and what you've
jammer there. That was Ipso Factopus again with Rowboat. Make sure to check those guys out on their Facebook. And just in case if you don't know how to spell their band name, it's IPSOFACTOPUS. Check those guys out. Recently, I have watched the movie The Interview, the latest comedy from Seth Rogen and James Franco. The movie is basically about, well, James Franco's a journalist, and he's instructed to assassinate North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, played by Randall Park, after booking an interview with him. In this movie, a lot of controversy going on. Basically, back in June of 2014, the North Korean government threatened merciless action against the United States if the film's distributor, Columbia Pictures, went ahead with the release. And Columbia delayed the release from October 10th to December 25th and reportedly edited the film to make it more acceptable to North Korea. In November, the computer systems of parent company Sony Pictures Entertainment were hacked by the Guardians of Peace, a group the FBI believes has ties to North Korea. After leaking several other than upcoming Sony films and other sensitive internal information, the group demanded that Sony pull The Interview, which is referred as to the movie of terrorism, on December 16, 2014. The Guardians of Peace threatened terrorist attacks against cinemas that played The Interview. Hilarious. And on December 17th, after a number of major North American cinema chains canceled screenings in the interest of safety, Sony canceled the theater release of The Interview, drawing criticism from the media. So A lot of BS came when this movie was supposed to be released. Now you can watch it on Netflix, if you have Netflix, as that's where I watched it. And the movie is hilarious. I mean, it's a great comedy, you know. Seth Rogen's previous release, Neighbors, I thought that movie was just, it was terrible. It wasn't funny. There was maybe one or two good scenes. Very, very long. I don't know what it is with these new up-and-coming comedy directors like Judd Apatow and stuff. When they think in their head they should make a comedy more than 2 hours long, when any regular normal comedy should be between an hour and 20 minutes to an hour and a half. Tops. I mean, it's a comedy. We're not watching the movie Platoon or Saving Private Ryan here, okay? It is just a comedy. And The Interview is about an hour and 45 minutes, but it doesn't seem long. It goes by really smooth. It's really funny. James Franco, hands down, is hilarious in this movie. He is out of his mind. And Seth Rogen, as his partner in it, did a brilliant job. Seth Rogen directed this as well. And I absolutely have no complaints about this movie. It's definitely, I think since it was banned from the theaters and everything like that, it's going to get that much more publicity. And that is the world of Hollywood as well. So, even though all this other background political mumbo jumbo with, you know, not being released, this could have been the plan from the get-go. Just, you know, some more people would watch it. And obviously, this is going to be a movie 20, 30 years down the line, it's going to be, everybody's going to be talking about it just because of what happened and it being banned. Not many movies have Ben band like this in this situation, I should say. But definitely go check it out. It's totally worth it. Definitely give it 2 thumbs up on that case. And yeah, love it. Definitely go check that out. And right after these messages, more music coming your way.
Listen, pet dick. How would you like me to make your life a living hell?
Well, I'm not really ready for a relationship, Lois, but thank you for asking. Hey, maybe I'll give you a call sometime. Your number's still 911? Alrighty then.
We'll be right back.
Yes, yes, yes. Mr. Nick Hexum there singing some blues from the Nick Hexum Quintet. That song was called You'll Do It Again. In music news, Incubus are back with another single that will be debuting on K-Rock February 5th. The new track, Absolution Calling, will hit the radio at 7:30 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So go check that out for all you Incubus fans out there. And in funny news, the San Francisco Zoo is giving the spurned and brokenhearted a new reason to mark Valentine's Day. That's right, for all you lovers out there, the chance to adopt a giant scorpion or hissing cockroach named after a heart-trampling ex. That is right, they're doing that at the San Francisco Zoo. How much more romantic can it get? She is a scorpion. Ha ha! True, true, true that. Well, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, once again for tuning in to Wheeler's Weekend Jams Radio. This is episode number 4. I hope you enjoyed it. Please go check me out at wheelersweekendjams.com and find me on my Facebook and Twitter. Remember, people, tune in, tune out every weekend right here on Wheeler's Weekend Jams Radio. Remember, don't take any shit from anyone. Breathe in, breathe out. Music is what it's all about. That is right, ladies and gentlemen. Have a good one.
How long y'all been going together?
Me and Pa been together 4 long years. Me and Dominique been best friends for 7 years.
What about this cook?
Dominique cooked pile chicken tetrazzini.
You think she has won him over with chicken tetrazzini?
I don't know what she do with the chicken tetrazzini, but Pyle love it. Pyle love it. Dominique can cook, but I know she's seducing my man with a chicken tetrazzini.